welcome to the final of the 15K tournaments. Let's get this show on the road. And I'm gonna ask the guys in chat, do you think that we should do a bracket tournament here or we should do a pool tournament? Because we only have 8 people. We could actually, I mean, I think with 8 fleets, this'll probably be about an hour if we did a pool tournament, or if we did a bracket tournament, it's only gonna be maybe about 15-20 minutes. So what do you guys think in chat? You wanna do pool? Definitely will make it more interesting because everybody here will get to fight everybody else. It's round robin, I believe it's what it's called in the outside world. So Feltier will get to fight Jota the Smooth, Replicators, Camden, Aetherin, Exciter, Amazing, and Sandstorm. It'll actually be way more realistic in terms of who's going to be on top. And of course, then everybody gets to fight everybody. And it will be much longer. So away we go, I think. Let's just get this started. Arter said bracket. Well, I don't know. You might want to skip ahead if you're waiting for your fleet here, but here we go. So we're starting off with Audi Cook Me and Amazing. And of course, Amazing, I don't know if this is the first time Amazing has been faced with such small ships. During the first rounds of tournaments, I don't think he faced such small ships all the way through. But yeah, notice right away, Amazing's ships got separated, and that's not very good for him. Whereas Audi Cook Me is kind of staying together. And Audi Cook Me, if you remember, he won all of part 2, which is fantastic. So he's fighting to get into the top 4, and all he's got to do is beat 3 of the competitors, I think, or 4 of the competitors to get into top 4. So I think he's actually taking down Amazing. This is incredible. I'm gonna zoom out here a little bit. Yeah, it looks like the Amazing's down to one ship. That's it. So numbers are beating Amazing. So I think, you know, if Amazing ships had stayed together, it is possible. I'll just autopilot here. If Amazing ships had stuck together, it might have been okay. But I don't think he's got enough firepower to be able to point defense to fight off all of these ships. Yeah. So there we go. Audi Cook Me, you got him first round. Excellent. Well done. Whoops. There we go. They're staying together, but yeah, like I said, I just don't think that Amazing has the point defense to be able to deal with this. Audi Cook Me, just the numbers. There is safety in numbers for sure. And it's such a simple design. It's simpler even. More simple. It is a simpler design than even these spinner designs that we're seeing. And the spinner designs are very, very simple. But Audi Cook Me has taken, you know, just root basics. It's 2 guns. There's no armor on his ships. It's 2 guns, a core, and 4 engines. That's it, folks. There's nothing else there. So, I don't know. You know, it's just that there's so many ships and they're able to dodge a lot of the shots that are coming at them, unlike a bigger ship, which is going to take a lot more hits. And, you know, it's just brilliant. So Amazing lost almost 100 ships there. Almost 100 ships. Or, sorry, not Amazing. Audi Cook Me lost almost 100 ships, but he won. So that does not mean Amazing is out of the competition. That is what is amazing about doing a pool competition. We don't usually do the pool tournaments because it takes a long, long time. And I couldn't imagine staying online and doing a 12-hour, 13-hour stream just to do a bracket or a pool tournament with like 100 people. That would probably even take longer than that. That would be ridiculous. So anyway, Amazing is back at it. So Amazing can still end up in the Final Four. That's the nice thing about not doing a bracket tournament, is that Amazing still has a chance to be in the Final Four because he's just got to beat 4 out of the 8 competitors here to remain, I think. I don't know. I don't know what the actual numbers would have to be for him to actually stay in it. But it looks like, his third ship just got destroyed. He didn't stick together like he usually does. He is getting nuked, which is not good. Jota the Smooth, and that was his kind of Jota's secret power here, is that he's got some sort of small skirmishing ships, and he's got some bigger ships with nukes. And the combination is brilliant because his bigger ships can kind of sit back here and launch the nukes while his little guys just kind of keep the ships occupied. And you know what? It is a brilliant tactic and it's working really well against Amazing. Sorry, Amazing. You're getting beat up, buddy. I'm so sorry. But it's, you know what? That's awesome. Good job, Jota the Smooth. That was really good. Really good. Really impressed. Okay, round 2. So yeah, here we go again. And if Amazing States can... Now, I haven't taken a close look at Amazing's small ships here. They're getting destroyed pretty quickly in the battle. And I'm wondering if maybe he made them just a little too big. Like, his little ships are maybe too big. Like, they're too slow, and they got destroyed too quickly. But even his bigger ships got crushed really quickly that time. It's crazy. Like, Amazing got... So, two full rounds of battles, and Amazing got crushed both times. I may do this from here on. You know what? Battling the final eight in a pool type thing is actually not a bad idea, because, yeah, it's amazing how different this is going. Amazing. I'm saying amazing a lot because Amazing's playing, and I like to say amazing, so... Joe to the Smooth, yes, just a couple more shots. Those nukes were brilliant. Just brilliant. Another reason I like Joe to the Smooth's fleet is that some people are writing upside down in the Steam chat. It's pretty awesome. Another reason I like Joe to the Smooth's fleet is all of his ships are not the same. They're all very, very different. Now, Amazing has, of course, a couple different ships here, but not quite the same variety. Well, I guess there's a lot of variety with this fleet, too, if you think about it. I mean, there's a lot of troll ships, a couple ships with nukes. Yes, Feltier has a couple ships with nukes as well. And he's also got, of course, some small kind of intercepting ships, as well as some medium intercepting ships. But what tends to happen more often than not is that people just fly into those big troll ships, like Amazing is about to do. Look at that! Self-sacrifice, Amazing. You've lost, like, five battles in a row here. What is going on, Amazing? Oh, this, Jonathan, how do you type upside down, guys? It must be a font choice, right? I don't know how you're doing that, but it's pretty cool. Yeah, so the people are just, that's why Feltier has done so well. It's, I hate to say it, but is this the meta? Is this the meta? People are building ships, or troll ships with... So if you look closely, I know I pointed this out last night, but if you look closely, there is melee armor on those troll ships. And for some reason, the AI flies into the troll ships. And I don't know why. It's not like Amazing ships are also Faction 7 and they have melee armor on them. It's incredible. I'm dying to know what's gonna happen against some of these spinner fleets, like Exciter's fleet. Like, is Exciter's fleet just gonna fly into... Oh, crazy. Okay, so now we have Amazing versus Aetherin, which is our Faction 4, our only Faction 4 fleet in this tournament. I think Amazing's gonna do better here. I think Amazing is designed to take on fleets with larger ships, and there we go. So yeah, so he's got the two ships flying together, launching all those dumbfire missiles. He's got the one kind of solo, trying to solo the two. That's maybe not a good choice. Aetherin may take this. Aetherin has smoked almost all of the ships. Amazing. Incredible. Incredibly is losing nonstop. Amazing hasn't won a fight yet. This is incredible. Incredible. There hasn't been a patch with Reassembly since, so I don't know, it's just Amazing maybe got lucky. It just depends on who you're fighting, and that's why, you know, the pool is great to determine the final winner, because we get a much better indicator of what the meta is, actually, when we do a pool fight, right? A pool fight. It's not a fight in a pool, but a pool, yeah, never mind. Awesome. Yeah, looks like Amazing's doing a little bit better this time. He has actually taken out almost all of Aetherin's ship. yeah, he's only got one more to go. That's it. So yeah, Aetherin. Oh, Amazing gets his first win today. So here we go. Round two. Will Amazing pull it off? Will he actually stay in this competition? I think he's already out now. I think no matter what, he cannot actually continue on and actually win a prize in this competition. But I mean, Amazing, of course, did really, really well in general. I'm keeping it zoomed out here to kind of see what goes on. Yeah, looks like all of Amazing ships are gone. There they go. Wow. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. So, Amazing, you won one fight, but lost every single battle so far. Incredible. Okay, here we go. Exciter's first fight. He is here. And he is, of course, faced with Amazing. Which normally I would say that would be trouble, but yeah, no, spinners, of course. And there has been varying degrees and levels of spinners. I mean, not all spinners are created equal, that is for sure. They may be simple designs, but they are definitely varying in quality, because we saw some really, really good ones like this fleet, of course, and we saw some spinners that weren't so great, that maybe didn't spin as fast as they could spin, and maybe didn't have quite the same kind of weaponry, and, you know, all those little things. But yeah, Exciter certainly has understands the concept of a spinner and how to make it work for him. There we go. Amazing wins or loses twice in a row. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. Okay, and Amazing versus Camden Walrev, Camo 5, who I suspect will probably do pretty good against Amazing ships as well. I don't think the Dumbfire missiles are a really great choice against spinners, small ships in general. The Dumbfire missiles are great against bigger ships because you're just relying on, you know, covering as much area as possible, but it doesn't really work when you're facing spinners. And just look at that. Just completely crushed Amazing. Amazing. Oh, absolutely incredible. Look at this, just crushed. Like, I gotta say, these battles are going very, very quickly. Thank you, Amazing. Your designs are incredible, Amazing. They always have been, but for some reason, every single fleet you've been faced with today, except for maybe Aetherian, you haven't stood a chance against. You've just been crushed. And if you are just tuning in with us now, and this is the first tournament you've ever seen, I want you to know that Amazing generally does extremely well in these competitions. He is a old-timer, you could say. He's been playing Reassembly probably, you know, since far before any of us even knew it existed. So for him to actually lose nonstop like this is insane. Look at the Sandstorm crushing him with his own unique mind spin. I call it a mind spin because he's got mines and he's spinning. And of course, the mines do enormous amounts of damage, like crazy, crazy damage. And of course, when you're spinning, it lobs the mines, whereas normally the mines, they just kind of sit there. Well, when you're spinning, they kind of launch and they fly at unnatural speeds. And of course, if this was real life, all of these spinners would, all the people actually flying the spinner ships would just be liquid, because their ships would spin them into liquid. And now we're on to Audi Cookme's rounds. I think this is Audi Cookme's rounds now. So now every fight we see will be Audi Cookme. He's going to fight through everybody except for, of course, Amazing, who he already beat. And it looks like he's just beating the snot out of, maybe not. He's down to 133 ships. I'm keeping zoomed out here because I don't know exactly what's going to happen. Okay, so it looks like he's taken care of most of the smaller ships. He's only got a couple of the bigger ships left in the center. Jonah, to pull out of this, you're going to have some well-placed nukes and kill a number of ships at once, or I don't know. I just don't know if it's even possible to have a ship at all with enough point defense to be able to take care of so many small Faction 1 ships. It's amazing that these ships don't even have armor on them. Audi Cookme ships don't even have armor. That's nuts. But yeah, and there's just so many of them, like, you just can't destroy them all. Look at that. And the nukes would have to be really well placed in order to destroy a number of ships. And, well, on Jonah's behalf, he has actually killed a number of Audi Cookme ships. Audi Cookme's down to 34 ships. He just lost another 20 from a well-placed nuke. Another 10! Audi Cookme only has 26 ships left! Oh my god! But Jonah has one ship, and that one ship has nukes. Just destroyed another 7 ships! Only 17 ships left for Audi Cookme. Is it possible? 15 ships! Jonah, you could actually pull this off. One second. Audi Cookme wins it from points. Unbelievable. Unbelievable! Unbelievable. The Jonah was so close. That was crazy. So yeah, the tactic for the AI with Audi Cookme ships is to divide and conquer. Look at that. He's taken away all those little ships, and one by one, he's taking care of those. Whereas, you know, he's got a few ships kind of melee. Wow, he's already lost almost 100 ships. Audi Cookme, you could lose this, but I don't know. And you can see the little ships, you know, that get damaged. They're grabbing parts from space, which is really amazing to try and do some quick repairs, but it's not a quick repair when you're dragging parts from across a galaxy. Look at that. Look, he's dragging parts from the middle. That's crazy. So yeah, there's a couple little skirmishes going on in the southwest quadrant, and we've got, of course, the big skirmish here in the southeast quadrant. But Audi Cookme's already down to 65 ships. He has applied way more damage in general, and it looks like he's probably going to win this again, unless Jada can figure out a way to destroy all those ships at once, and, you know, all it would take is, imagine a nuke in that blob right there. A couple good, well-placed nukes would take care of most of them. Audie Cookme is down to 55 ships, but Jada still has 5. And there's only 20 seconds left to go. I don't think there's a chance of Jada pulling it off. Oh my god! Yeah, Jonathan James is asking where Jops is. Jops did not make it into the final four in his round, or in his I think it was part one. We had Jops. Maybe it was part two. I don't know. But yeah, they're pretty incredible. Anyway, Audie Cookme, yeah, you won it by points again. Well done. Audie Cookme, well done. Johnny, you did great. It's just, and you're not done because we are doing pool here. So now we are doing, this is the one I was kind of worried about. Audie Cookme, look, he is just smashing himself against all of these Faction 7 troll ships. No! Mass suicides. This is crazy. Don't drink the Kool-Aid. Don't do it. Oh, no. Oh, no. No, no. They're like lemmings. I can hear the I can't remember the lemmings music from the video game, but I can just picture it. Look at them. No, it's terrible. This is a tragedy. You know what? Feltier is going to win this because of this. That's unbelievable. Unbelievable. Of course, we all know this is a bug and this has got to get fixed. And I don't even know how to prevent this. In future tournaments, it has to be fixed. The AI has to be able to dodge. It has to recognize when a ship has melee armor on it and dodge, because that's ridiculous. This is unbelievably ridiculous. It's funny. I will admit that it's really, really funny, but yeah, the ships are literally just killing themselves. Like, even if Audie Cookme's ships did survive this little skirmish here, which I don't think they will, look at all these nukes just circling. Feltier, I would say that this is an exploit, but I mean, you may or may not have known that this is an exploit, but either way, it's super funny. It's super funny. It doesn't mean that Audie Cookme's out of the race, it just means that he's not going to win this fight, just so you know, because you only have to get top four to be part of the winner's circle here in our tournaments, so... That way, you know, like, stuff like this, because it happens, right? I mean, who would have known that all of these ships would just ram melee armor? This has got to be fixed, honestly. And so, you know, we're gonna of course send a bug report to Anisopter Games, and hoping that they kind of fix the AI in this respect, because the AI, it should kind of dodge. My opinion is, if you see big blobs with melee armor on it, don't drive into it. That's my opinion. And sometimes it counts, sometimes it doesn't, but sometimes it does. All right, so we've got Aetherin and his Dragon Fleet. I love the name, by the way. And the only Faction 4 fleet. And of course, you're facing Audie Cookme, and it doesn't look promising. Audie Cookme, in his very simple, highly repetitive design, is simply just crushing you. Ah, just brutal. The actual Slim Shady, yes, I missed you. I just saw your chat thing. I'm only catching some of the chat most of the time I'm watching this, but yeah, welcome back to the stream. Yeah, we got 31 people. Not bad for a mid-afternoon on a Saturday. all the hardcore people are here. That's fantastic. But yeah, Audie Cookme, you're just... Oh yeah, that's insane. Well, that's nice that you left, you know, you left the housing of a ship. That's really nice of you. All right, so now we've got... yes, Exciter versus Audie Cookme. This is going to be interesting. Like, I don't know what's happening. I have no idea. I don't even know where I am half the time. And this is no exception, because when you start getting spinners versus little tiny ships, I suppose we could follow the progress of one little battle here, just to kind of see how it progresses. It looks like, you know, Audie Cookme is actually hitting the Exciter ships, but unfortunately, Audie Cookme has not destroyed one Exciter ship yet. So... I don't understand. Exciter? Yeah, so here's the thing also. With Exciter ship, as well as Camel 5 ship, they are using Faction 7. And the little blocks that they're using to build their ships, I believe, is that really awesome armor. And it's not that they can't die, because now he has lost 3 ships. It's just they can take a lot of damage. So not only is he spinning really fast, lobbing projectiles at unnatural rates, and kind of breaking physics almost, and on top of that, they're really well armored and hard to hit. So, I don't know. I think, yeah, Exciter's got a pretty good design. Will he be able to not fly into the big troll ships with melee armor on it? I don't know. But wait, it's not over, folks. Onikukmi has 26,000 points and he is gonna win it. Unbelievable. Hey, Aetherin, you know what? He's saying spinners are OP. Yes, they're OP, but guess what? Onikukmi won. Onikukmi is not using spinners. Unbelievable. Excuse me for 1 second. I have to let my cat out. Cat's scratching at the door. All right, here we go. Sorry, guys. Sorry about that. Yeah, Onikukmi applying tons of damage. It's just, you know, those little armor blocks. It's crazy. So what? Yes. Meow, my cat. I try to get the cat out of the room before I start, but sometimes I forget because she's sneaky. She's very, very sneaky. Anyway, so yeah, Onikukmi just did a lot of damage. And the weird thing is, so because Exciter Ship are they're so hard to hit and they can take so much damage, Onikukmi can apply a lot of damage and not kill the ship. The ship flies away, heals itself a little bit, and then Onikukmi can apply more damage, which is good for Exciter, but also bad because, of course, he loses by points. And that's exactly what's happening here. Spinners lose again to Onikukmi. This is not the first time we've seen this already. Onikukmi. And it's too simple. It's crazy. So I just wonder if it's even possible to build a fleet that's not melee troll ships that can beat something like Onikukmi's very simple but very unique design. I mean, nobody else has had anything like it in this competition yet. It's crazy. It's absolutely crazy. All right, here we go. Now we've got Onikukmi versus Microtorp by Camo 5. And of course, Camo 5 is using a very similar design, but different. His is asymmetric, which I love. I've always loved asymmetric designs. I hate building them because I kind of start to twitch. You know how when you're really stressed, your eyelid starts to vibrate? I don't know if that happens to anybody else, but with me, when I'm building asymmetrical ships, my right eyelid starts to like shiver. like it's really cold, like it's vibrating, it's really weird. And when I'm building asymmetrical ships, that's exactly what happens. And it drives me crazy, and I end up pulling up my eyelid, and it's just trying to stretch it and kind of, you know, massage it a little bit. It's weird. Anyway, so yeah. Anyway, Onikukmi's winning. I don't know if you guys come here for the tournament or for my antics. I don't know. I don't know why I'm here either. Sometimes I don't know what I'm doing. I look at my life and I go, what is happening? But yeah, I really, yeah. So that's the thing, is we know what's going to happen here, right? I mean, of course, Camo 5 has 118 ships left and Onikukmi only has 80 ships left. But it doesn't matter because Onikukmi is just applying way more damage. It's the same deal. Camo 5 has that really awesome armor, which is great, which means it can take a lot of damage, which means he can get hit and then fly away and then get hit some more because he got healed and stuff, but he just dies by points. So there's nothing, absolutely nothing that he can do but lose to Onikukmi. Do I think it's going to be the same throughout the competition? No, I think Camo 5 is going to do really well in the rest of the competition. He'll probably end up being part of the final four, and him and or Exciter will be, but against Onikukmi, how do you defend against this nonsense? Against four engines, two guns, and a core. That's it. They don't spin. They don't do anything weird. It's just, it's crazy. I don't understand it. How does that happen? I have to know. I know Onikukmi's watching right now. Onikukmi, did you test this fleet? Like, it's unbelievable. Like, how did you figure out that you just slap together a couple parts and it's just gonna work so well like this? It's crazy. Or did you just hope for the best? You just thought, oh, I'll just do something really small a ship as I could possibly build. And I wonder what would happen if you just put one gun on there. Would it be just as good? And then you could do, you know, twice as many ships, or, you know, a third more ships or something. You'd do like 200 and some, I don't know. Did you do much testing? Anyway, I'm curious. At least I think he might have left, I don't know, but he was online here. I'd be curious to know how that all worked, but or how what his process was for putting this fleet together. It might have been that it was late at night, he was really tired, he was drunk. And he thought, well, I'll just slap together a couple parts and hope for the best. And it works. It's crazy. Okay, so there we are. So we have got 27,000 points versus 2,200. Yes, so that's it. It's all over. Well done, Audie Cookie. Yay! You know what? People are going to ban you. It's crazy. Ban Audie Cookie. Cheats. Yeah, I don't think he cheats. I think it was just luck. Yeah, see, he said right now he didn't do much testing. So this is a late night drunken build where he didn't test it. He's just like, I'm just going to put as many ships in on the screen as possible. And he's done that. 178 ships. Well, I don't think we saw a fleet that big. Yes, we got to ban everything. Frostflight, Sing and Chant. We have to ban everything because it's all so overpowered. Yes, and I'm sure, I know I could build a ship or a fleet of ships that could build, that could beat Audie Cookme, but I don't know if it would beat anything else, because you'd have to build just ships filled with point defense, very specific types of point defense, and I think it could be done, but I don't think I'd be able to beat other people's fleets with that kind of ship, so I don't know, it'd be really interesting. I'm of course, we can't ban Audie Cookme's ships, they're just, there's nothing, there's no, how do you, I don't know. We could have specific tournaments where we say each ship must be a certain size and such. And we might do that too. I don't know. It does bring up a lot of questions as to what we do going forward, right? But actually, Audie Cookme is about to lose against Sandstorm. Against the spinner. Audie Cookme, this is the first loss you've had. Oh, I'm actually feeling kind of bad. Sandstorm, with his mind-spinning design, has beaten Audie Cookie. Audie Cookie. Audie Cook Me! he's unbelievable. So here's the thing. All those mines that they're lobbing, they just stay out in the field, right? So they actually don't go away. They stay until the battle's done. Or they might have a time limit or something, but it might be like a minute and a half, but a battle only lasts a minute and a half, so these mines just sit out in the field, and I bet you that is how Audie Cookme is losing here. It's hard to see exactly what's happening, but yeah, those mines, they're probably hitting them quite a bit just from lobbing them from the ship, but at the same time, like I said, they're just lying around in the field, so they don't hurt Sandstorm when he runs into them, but they certainly hurt Audie Cookme. So, but he still has 44 ships left, only 38 seconds to go! Can he pull it off? Most of Sandstorm's ships are getting occupied by one or two of Audie Cookme's ships this time, so I don't think he's going to be able to pull it off unless all of Audie Cookme's ships fly into those mines. And I just saw it happen. I just saw one actually fly into those mines. So that's exactly what's happening. The mines are brilliant against the small ships. Brilliant. Brilliant! I absolutely love it, but I think Sandstorm... No! Audie Cookme still could win by points! Ah, crazy! So yeah, I think it's 1-1 here, but it's really nice to see that Audie Cookme did get beaten at least once. Yeah. So tiebreaker, here we go! Look at this crash! I love it! Look at the carnage! Absolute carnage. I'm starting to understand the battles a little better when I'm watching it from this height. It's tricky. I still picture a petri dish and a battle going on in a petri dish. All these bacteria fighting against each other and amoebae and a paranemesium and, you know, just... I just picture this really aggressive microbial battle, right? So... Or, you know, nanotechnology, like nanoviruses or something, like, not like the nanoviruses, like the race I built, but like, you know, like microscopic machines that battle bacteria, and Audie Cookme is the disease, and Sandstorm is the cure. Sorry, Audie Cookme, I didn't mean to call you a disease. I meant the replicators are a disease, and Sandstorm's the cure. I shouldn't actually say that people are a disease, that's probably a bad idea. I know he has a good sense of humor, though, so that's okay. So we're down to 17 versus 32. Audie Cookme is losing those ships fast. He's down to 14. 20 seconds to go. Can he pull it off? I don't think so. Well, maybe. Sandstorm has more points this time, somehow, and he's only down to 5 ships. 5 ships versus 31. Sandstorm lost, like, no ships this time. That's crazy. So I wonder if those mine launchers, how many hit points those mine launchers actually have on the sides of the Sandstorm ship too. Plus he has armor on his ship too as well. Just a lot more, they can take a lot more damage. Yeah, he only lost one ship. Well done, Sandstorm. Adi Kukmi actually lost a battle. Crazy. But he won five. But, you know. Okay, now we're going to see all the battles using Joda the Smooth. All right. And, of course, man, really? Oh, well, looked like he nuked one of them. That's good. But, oh, man, they all just flew. Oh, that's so brutal. That's so brutal. So it looks like he's got one more ship up here. Oh. He's still alive. He's nuking. He actually nuked like three or four of those. One, two, three, four, five, six of the big old troll ships. Seven troll ships now dead. He's got to kill a few more. Oh, he's actually, he has melee armor on his ship. That's why. So with melee armor, you're able to defend, when you fly into the melee armor, but it doesn't get destroyed instantly because you already have melee armor. So that is the Achilles heel to this troll ship design, is melee armor of your own. Brilliant. Look at this. He's almost got it. One more to go. Oh, maybe there's another one. Oh, yeah, there's one more troll ship. Oh, and there's a, what were they doing up there? They must have been fighting one of Jonah's other ships up north. But, oh, no, there's nukes coming in. Oh, man. Well, this is the best we've seen anybody do against Feltier so far, I think. Pretty crazy. Crazy. Absolutely. I just love it. But how many ships? Not all of his ships, I think, have the... Yeah, see, not all of his ships have the melee armor. Those ships fly directly into those troll ships, and it's all over. And it looks like all of the ships, I'm just double-checking, yeah, all of the ships are actually in the center now this time. And it doesn't look like Joda the Smooth is doing as well this time, even though... Yikes! I mean, he didn't win last time either, but he did really well! He did really well against that for the first time. All right, so now we've got Joda versus Aetherion's Dragon Fleet. And the only Faction 4 fleet against a Faction 7, and Faction 7's done very, very well. I would say that Faction 7 is the dominating force in the final 8, for sure. I think most of them are Faction 7, even the spinners, except for one, is Faction 7. So Faction 7 is definitely a force to be reckoned with when it comes to fleets. They're a technologically advanced faction. I mean, just with the nukes themselves. I mean, that in itself is pretty technologically advanced. And then, of course, to have melee armor, which has been incredibly valuable in these tournaments. I'd say, what if there was any one piece that could attribute the most damage in this tournament at all, it would be melee armor. I think the melee armor has done far more damage than anything. Although Faction 4, you know, a good skirmish, and these are not snipers, so I want everybody to be clear. You know, a sniper is a ship that shoots and then backs off, right? It uses the power of the weapon to jerk it backwards and stay away from the enemy. And snipers haven't done very well in this competition at all because of that border. But these skirmish ships, which are different than snipers, they actually can keep a nice range to the enemy, have actually done quite well all along. It's surprising. So it's the only Faction 4 fleet we've done that's quite well, or that has done quite well. And I don't think we had a lot of Faction 4. I think people realized right away that was going to be an issue. But yeah, Aetherion, you've pulled it off. Well done. Well done, my friend. Well done. Joda again versus Aetherion. Here we go. And yeah, so that the melee armor is taking some chunks out. You can actually see they took out the chunk of the front end of one of those ships already. And yeah, it's really cool to watch that melee armor just cut through the enemies, just like you do when you're playing by yourself. It's actually pretty neat. But it's not enough. It's not enough. Just the right combination. Right amount of those Faction 4 modular guns with the right amount of firepower placed correctly, and yeah, you're able to fight off, you know, some of these really highly aggressive melee fleets, which is crazy. Yeah, they did kind of get you cornered there, though. Oh, but you still got them. Well done. Well done. Well done. So only these little guys, I'm surprised the little guys made it that far, but yeah. And these Aetherion ships look a lot like Camel 4's, or Camel 4. Camel 5's ships. Some of his past ships. So it's obviously a winning design. Well done. Well done. All right. So now we've got Jocrates in his Joda the Smooth fleet versus, of course, Exciter. Wow. Wow. Easy boy. Holy. Yeah, Exciter just didn't waste any time. Just went to town. He's like, that's it. He's mad. He lost the battle. He's mad. I'm mad. Yeah, no messing around. Wow. Just like that. All right, now we've got... who's fighting? We're on to... Oh, no, so Camel 5. All right, so we're still on Joda the Smooth. And Camel 5, and I think Camel 5 is going to take it. The spinners take it. But, you know, I still think the most brutal force we've seen so far, although the spinners are pretty good. Yeah, I admit, the spinners are pretty good. Aside from Audi Cook Me, is that troll fleet with the melee armor. It's insane. I almost want to talk to the designer just to, you know, see what kind of designing he did. And if you figured that out, that ships would always fly into those troll ships. Because what a discovery. Just amazing. Amazing! All right, so now we have... Sandstorm versus Joda. Sorry, I couldn't see the line for some reason. There was a lot of lines there, and I was looking for yellow, not red. So yeah, the spinners, I think, are going to take it again. Yep, spinners take it again. But Joda, you did really well. You did really well, considering what you're up against, and you did really well. I don't beat yourself up. You've done very, very well in this competition overall. So yeah, good job. These spinners, though, and keep in mind, folks, spinners will... We're pretty sure, and we're going to do a vote on it, but I'm pretty sure that spinners are going to be out for the next one. And we've got to do something. We've got to talk to the developer about the AI when it's dealing with troll ships, because, the melee troll ships, because that's a problem. Although, it doesn't look like... It doesn't... You're welcome, Jocrates. He's actually online right now. So, yeah, it looks like Theron's doing okay. He hasn't actually flown into the bad guys yet, but he's got his modular weapons that keep him away from the enemy, like when he's firing, because it propels him backwards. So, I don't know what's going to happen. Is he going to fly up to them after he's dealt with all the bad guys here? I don't know. Hard to say. and this may be another really good weapon against, of course, the troll design, the melee troll design, which has been... notoriously brutal already. It's just wow. Although Aetherian, you actually got to hit him. You're wasting a lot of time with that guy, but you've applied all the damage. Yeah, so as long as you do not ram, here's the ultimate question: will Aetherian actually ram the melee fleet like everybody else has? The modular weapons won't stand a chance. They won't make it through all of that, I don't think so. But, and it looks like he's not going to ram, so brilliant. Oh, maybe one of them might. One of them might actually ram. Uh-oh. No, turn. Don't do it. No, life is so good. Don't give up. No. He's still alive. He's repairing, but yeah, there's a lot of nukes. Oh, man. A lot of damage. He did eventually kill himself. There we go again. All right, so same deal. Is he gonna kill all these guys? That was the best way to do it. I think the AI was really good. Actually, the AI did a good job. I think as far on Aetherian's behalf, it did a great job. He beat up the little guys and the big guys, and then he went after the troll ships afterwards. So he applied all of his damage before he even met up with the troll ships. As long as he doesn't die at that point, he's okay. Of course, you have no control over what the AI is gonna do, and actually that would solve... Hey, developer, Arthur Danskin, if you're ever watching these tournaments, that would solve the problem with these troll ships. Give us options when we're designing our fleets on how we, like, I want to be able to assign behavior to my ships and my fleets on how they behave against ships. And if that was there, we could tell our ships not to ram. That's one thing, you know, against Faction 7 or melee armor, we'll avoid melee armor. That would be so cool. And here we go. Oh, no. Oh, they stopped at the last minute and didn't ram it. That was brilliant. They used the gun to propel themselves backwards and, of course, avoid an untimely death. Yeah, so if Arthur Danskin, if you're ever watching this, you know, adding it so that we could apply behaviors to the ships would make it... would, of course, just add so much to the tournaments overall in general. And, of course, would make things like this not as important, because you could tell your fleets to avoid melee armor, which works in this scenario, but wouldn't work so much against ships that have melee armor that can move really quickly, because you'd still have to dodge those, and sometimes you can't always dodge those. But, and that is a little bit more fair. But anyway, good job, Aetherian. Really good job. I really impressed. Exciter against the... Will Exciter just ram all the ships? Oh, he is! He's ramming the ships! No, don't do it, Exciter! No! No! Of course, there's a lot of people that hate spinners that are going, oh, or that dislike spinners, that are going, oh, this is perfect, it's justice. But at the same time, it seems a little unfair. Oh, man. Oh, Exciter. Yeah, good job, Feltier. Good job. Although Exciter has done 251,000 points of damage, all he's got to do is live for 50 seconds. He's got five ships. Can he do it without ramming? I don't know. He's got one ship out here that's kind of meandering away, but he's got some nukes coming after him. That's not good. There's a lot of nukes too. Look at them all. Oh, no, so close. Will he? But he's going to come and he's going to ram. Don't ram. Don't ram. It's a bad idea. He's only got two ships left. No, you would win this. You would win this. Oh. No! Oh! Oh, no! Oh, Exciter. Oh, man. Yeah, so behaviors. We need behaviors for ships. That would be amazing. And if there was, if you could not only assign one behavior, but assign conditions, you know, like some light programming to your ships, you know, say, if I'm faced with this kind of ship, or if I'm faced with this type of armor, do this behavior. That would be amazing. That would be so good. It would be a lot of work, I know, for the developer. And I know he's just a small, he's a small team. He is a small team because he's essentially one guy. So, but that would be really cool. But even one behavior would be amazing. A general behavior that your fleet generally adheres to, or a couple behaviors that your fleet adheres to, would be just incredible. I don't know how much that work that would do based on the infrastructure of the programming that you put together already, Arthur, but that would be so cool. Either way, it looks like Exciter's down to five ships. And of course, he's trying to kill himself. Oh no. There it goes. Four ships left. Is he actually gonna, I don't know where they are. There they are. Okay, there's one. Oh no, don't do it. Oh man, all that work repairing your ship and then he just rammed. There's one more there and there's, so three ships left. I only see one. Maybe there's one in the corner. He may actually pull this off. He's gonna pull it off. His ships are too far away to do anything stupid. Yes, so he's got it. Right on, well done. Woohoo! Alright, so Exciter, can he do it again? This is tense. I bet Exciter, who's watching this, if he's watching this right now, on either on YouTube or live, is kind of freaking out. This is intense. Will he pull this off? I don't know. I don't think so. He's lost 90%, well, 50% of his ships, 75% of his ships already. Oh no, seven ships left. I don't think, six ships left. So the only way he's going to win this is with a stray ship like this, because he's done all the points damage that he needs, that he needs to do to win the battle. But he could pull it off. 50 seconds. All he's going to do is stay awake, because I have a feeling these ships, even if they do win against these, all these nukes. Oh no, no, watch. No, oh no, nuke. No, dodge, go left. No. That's the thing about nukes, is they all also fire a little gun too. Yeah, he lost there. And here comes another one, suicide. I can't take it. It's so hard, I can't deal with life. Don't ever do this, folks. There's always a reason to live. That's terrible. Always a reason to live. No! Oh, life is so good. You don't want to just ram some melee ship. That's too bad. It's too bad. But good job, Feltier, I suppose. You're the only one that came up with that, so I guess I have to give you credit for it. Camo5, will you do the same? I have a feeling that we're going to see much the same here. Oh, and it doesn't mean, Feltier probably still won a prize. All you got to do is get Final Four here to win a prize. And honestly, everybody in Final Eight did just fantastic. You got to give everybody credit. Everybody in this, you know what? There isn't a ship design in this game that I dislike. I even like the spinners. I think they're a little unfair for the tournaments, but I still like this. I like all the designs. And it's not that I like everything all the time. It's just, I like this game. I just like the originality of everybody's design. It's pretty crazy. Even the simple design, even Camo 5's simple spinning design is still different than everybody else's spinning design. It's unique in its own way, and it's asymmetrical, and you gotta give him credit for that. Camo 5's ships are not ramming like everybody else's were. So explain that. Is it because his ships just don't move as fast, I think? They only have the two engines on them. Maybe they're just not as, they're not as impulsive as some of these other types, but they're still ramming, just not as aggressively. It looks like maybe they've taken off all of the melee armor on a couple sides of these ships so that when they are hitting them, they aren't actually dying. Wow, incredible, but they're moving and they're going into places where there is melee armor because I don't know why. Camo 5, no! So people are even saying his spinning ships are even black magic. Like there's black magic, he's just, but I don't know. 723,000 points of damage, really? 723,000 points of damage, unnatural. How does he do this? If you're new to the tournaments and this is the first video you've ever watched, Camo 5 has unnatural abilities. Hold on. Let me clarify this. And don't take any offense to this, Camo 5. I've said a lot worse. So, it's not that he's an absolutely brilliant designer, but he's a highly knowledgeable designer. He knows so much about the inner workings of the game that he's able to use black magic and all sorts of other dark forces to create magical designs that do things that shouldn't do what you'd expect them to do. Unlike Exciter, who's just a really good designer that probably playtests his stuff. Camo 5 just, no, I'm sure he playtests it. I'm just picking on you, Camo 5. I know you do, I know you spend a lot of time with this game, but really, you designed a fleet that I don't understand. How did you do this? It's gotta be black magic. It's crazy! Unfair. Totally. Camo 5, you're banned. That's it. It's over. You're not banned. I'm just kidding. Fun to say, though. It's always fun to say that somebody's banned. Rage quit. We'll rage quit for you. we'll say that Camo 5 rage quit, but we really weren't banning him. No, we're not banning anybody. We do have to do something about this melee armor design because The reason I see that is because I worry that the next tournament is all going to be this. Although, if every fleet was a troll fleet design like that, then nobody would do any damage because they'd be so far away from each other, or they'd all nuke each other to death. So I guess, you know, we shouldn't disallow it because there's an easy way to fight a fleet like that is build another fleet just like it. Sandstorm, no! It's because of the speed of the ships. The ships are just faster, and they're just more erratic. The more erratic, the faster your fleet, especially spinners. Look at that. Wow. It's like lemmings, and everybody that dislikes spinners are just cheering for joy. They're just like, yeah! I don't blame you. Yeah, it's pretty poetic justice for a pretty unnatural, unrealistic design, but then, I don't know. Aetherian in chat here just said that Arthur Danskin is actually Camo 5 in disguise, and I wouldn't be surprised at all. Oh, wouldn't that be sneaky? So Arthur Danskin being the developer of Reassembly, that would be super funny. Exposed. That's brilliant. All right, so what do we got left here? We're just about done. I think we're just about done. Here we go. Aetherian versus Exciter. I'm pretty sure we're going to see Exciter crush it. I'm pretty sure. Aetherian, you've got a great Faction 4 fleet, but it just doesn't stand a chance against spinning designs. Not like that. Not that spinning design. There's no way. Yeah, sorry. You lasted longer than some other people. Yeah, and Arthur Danskin. Arthur, you're fired. Sorry, I've been watching a lot of Trump in the news, so I'm just like, Arthur, you're fired. You're fired. I am Canadian, so I can't be a Trump supporter, nor am I otherwise. There, you've got my political point of view too as well. I do not support Trump. I'm not going to vote for him in the Canadian election. There we go. Aetherian versus Camo 5. I think that Camo 5 is going to take this. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I would be really surprised, but he's lasting quite a while. You know, Camo 5, you're not quite as efficient as Exciter in a lot of ways, but you don't fly into things as unnaturally as other people. So, I don't know. Either way, why is it, I don't know. Ban the color pink. No more pink! I don't like the way it looks. I just don't like it. It scares the enemy. There we go. Yeah, yeah, not quite as fast, you know? Camo 5, what's wrong with you? It's way too slow. too funny. Anyway, so there we go! All done. Aetherin versus Sandstorm. Aetherin, of course, he's actually done, he's lasted longer than just about any of the other fleets with spinning designs, so that is pretty cool. He's actually destroyed a whole, he's destroyed almost over 10 of Sandstorm's ships, so that's pretty good, right? But unfortunately, that's it. I think Sandstorm's just gonna, yeah, that's it. It's all over. Well, maybe not. No, it's all over. There we go. Good job. Anyway, again, you lasted longer than some other people. Sandstorm, here we go again. Of course, those mines just do so much damage. I don't know how much damage they do versus energy and stuff, but they're pretty good. I think they're one of the higher, most damaging weapons. Here we go, what we've all been waiting for, Exciter versus Camo 5. This is it. This is it. Camo's down to 115 ships out of his 180. Exciter's down to half. Crazy. Absolutely amazing. Camo's under 100. Exciter's down to 12. Exciter, I think, has a little bit better design in terms of applying damage, but Camo 5 is just, he's got so many ships. I think that's the key to Camo 5's power here. He's got a spinning design, but he does so much. But he avoids the shots. Like, I don't know. Sorry, I'm focused on the battle here. I'm not really... There we go. Awesome. Camo, you pulled it off. I actually wasn't sure that you were going to be able to do that. It's just numbers. It's strictly numbers at this point. I'm not paying attention to chat. I know somebody's trying to chat with me in chat, and I was getting distracted by that. I'm not chatting right now. You can talk to me after the tournament. So yeah, Exciter, you're down to 7 already. I actually thought you were going to win this. I thought Exciter's ships were better overall, but I was wrong. Camo 5, it's just, wow, crazy. Camo 5 pulled it off. Unbelievable. So, Camo 5, once again, we all have to ask the question, how? How do you do this? It's insane. Oh, Sandstorm! Oh, one more! Hold on. So far, I think it's 5-5-5. I think the top contenders have 5 each, so I don't know. It's still up in the air. We still don't know who is the definitive winner until we actually see the final number here. I kind of missed it. I'm not really paying attention to that. So, looks like Exciter is going to beat Sandstorm, though. I thought Sandstorm would do better, those mines. But no. Crazy. Crazy. Okay, yeah, Exciter, well done. Well done. And you only lost a little over 10 ships. Fantastic. Sandstorm, here we go. Come on, do the damage. He just, yeah, Exciter, those must be tracking missiles. It's hard to say. Yeah, they've got to be tracking missiles of some kind. But yeah, they just apply, he's just getting more hits. He's more accurate. I think that's what the key is. Exciter's fleet is more accurate. So yeah, so 5 wins for Camden, 5 wins for Feltier, 5 wins for Adikukmi. Camden, here we go against Sandstorm. This could be the tiebreaker, I think. This could put Camden on top. I don't know. We may have a tie, and I don't know how I'm going to deal with that. Torpedoes. Yes. So Daddy just pointed out that Exciter is using torpedoes. Interesting. Very interesting. Interesting. Oh, here we go. Camo 5 pulls it off, of course. Ah, crazy. Big, heavy, damaging torpedoes, people are saying. So, yeah. But Camo, yeah. Unnatural. I don't even know what to say anymore. Honestly? Or should I say Arthur? Yeah, I know you're not Arthur. Is that it? That's it. Camo wins the whole competition at 6 wins. I'm going to have to take a closer look because I think we kind of had a tie thing kind of happening, didn't we? I don't know. You know what? I'm not going to do this tournament again because I really wanted to take the top 4, but I don't think we really had a good indication of who that top 4 were. I could go back and figure it out, but well, here's what I'm going to do. For the final 8 of the 15,000 P tournament. I think we're just going to give a Steam key, a random Steam key to everybody who was in this final eight. I think that's the fair thing to do. I think all you guys did absolutely fantastic. It was really fun and great to watch you guys fight too. So thank you very much for entering. And there you go. And tomorrow is the 35,000 P tournament. And we're going to be starting that at 5 p.m. MTN. So yeah, there we go. All right, guys. Have a good one. Take care.